just turn around to make it visible a bit. So just wanted to know, picture how this is
Now, do you have to have the stringer there in order to place the handrail there?
Well, that's the thing that I want to explain when we go and do shift K. No, you just shift K. So when we have a stair has a left side and a right side. But the edges are green, so those are all good, whatever shape you have. And this is the starting, where it's purple. And those are the end points purple. And on each path, I can have one stringer, and I can have one handrail linked to that stringer. But if I go to this balustrade, as an example, a balustrade is actually more parts together. It has one handrail on top, and then it doesn't really have limitation in how many horizontal parts you want to have underneath it, and also what kind of sideways position you want to have it. And also we can have more slots, you see here. So some horizontal parts you may want to have with a different concept with others. So we do have some options to add extra parts here. But as basic, it is that Staircom sees we have a stair shape. We have a left side, a right side, and then many stringers as you want. And on top of those stringers, we can put balustrades. And these balustrades can also be offset, yes or no. And that's a little bit what I did as work around here. But this one is to say, I want to have this handrail that has this shape actually as a balustrade on this trigger, and it goes automatically with a specific offset and a specific offset down. And when we look at it in 3D, and it shows like this. If I would go and I say F7, I go to the other one I just did, and I made your already a 3D file zero for you. So these are maybe not 100% correct, but looks a little bit more similar as what you have. Still correct?
Yeah. Yep.
So also this, if I click on it, it's actually a 3D SDR file. So if I look in the, so you see this, this is actually GD metal support, and in GD metal support.3dp, I can show you what it does. So if I go to the other screen, so you go to your users, public.
So if you draw the stringer as a handrail, you have to put an invisible stringer wherever you want an actual handrail on each.
So this is the SDL that I made.
Right, that's what you're getting.
So this is the 3D file that I made, and this one I think works. I go back to the other one. It's using GD metal support dot 3DP. I open this. I say this you can always open the notepad. So here I said, whatever I'm going to import, please make it as a metal finish so that it looks always like a glaze thing. If I would put black or whatever, then it's going to be black. In this case, I just say metal. Then I say what it has to do, import the SDL. And then this is the SDL. And this is X, Y, Z, A, B, C, how it has to turn. So it depends on how you design the thing. I turn it around and loop it around. So as you this file, I selected actually in Staircom, go back to the other side. that he has to use this as a baluster. So here I have my hand rail, here I have my baluster, and he's inboarding this one based on the position of my baluster view and elevation view. And this baluster and elevation view just looks like one small short line, but actually based on the location of this line, it's placing that thing in 3D. And this model, as you can see, is already open and has already this balustrade attached to it, because that's the thing that I just did this morning. I open up here, I go to model, and you see here some example models that I added. And then you see, okay, if we take the GD double or GD center metal, the thread thickness is 3.5. The trigger thickness here is 4. Here I don't have that. The wall trigger is here also 4. And then these, we say that they're cut triggers. These, I said that they're invisible. If I go back. Here I made some stair starts and ends. Remember that this one has already a balustrade on top of it. So with saying in the stair start, I go there to show you. Stair start. Here is the GBSQ 1.5. So this is the starting post that I added the post in the database, and I called it GD square 1.5. And that it's starting 0 at the post placement, so it's in front of my tread. And if I go to my stair end, I also made a stair end GD square 1.5. And here I have a stair dimension and an ending post. And this ending part is on all to part 1.5. So you see that everything that is linked towards that model, because if I go here to this model, you see that these handrails are also linked to this. So you see, illustrate that. So the other one, other two, I didn't put any handrails for the stair itself, only when there's a wall. And then I put this stringer thing, and for the double stringers here, I put a handrail type for the floor and for the stair.
Still there?
Okay.
There.
So it does take. Hello.
Yeah.
Okay. So it as you can see. It's all linked to each other, but that makes it a little bit more work to get it in, because if you want to have the balustrade, as an example, you first have to have this balustrade. If you want to link it to the model, you first have to have exactly that balustrade already here in your database. So I made here a balustrade called GD somewhere, GD metal ensemble, and then it has to have a specific handrail, and I didn't have the handrail, so then I made a handrail, so then you go one more deeper and you say there's handrails. So then I make a handrail with the big GD square, and this is the width and this is the height. So then I go back to the balustrade. Then I can use this handrail. Then I can pick this handrail out of the list. So if I make this handrail in the spreadsheet handrail, and I can pick it from here if I want to use it in my balustrade. And the same for the slots. The slots is actually how you want to have the infill. And I made an infill how you want to have the handrail and how you want to have the horizontal and the vertical part. So also if I go to these slots, you see that I have these two slots. I go now to this balustrade slots. See that I made here two types of slots. The 1.5 and be safe. And then you see that I had a specific height for the first horse bar, and here you see the baluster legs, and here you see the bottom grass tanks, and the set that I wanted to have, maybe six. Was the first one on top that makes seven. Depending on how many